We all know that Saina Nehwal and PV Sindhu are two of the most prominent Indian badminton players across the globe. Both have enjoyed a lot of success and won a lot of medals, be it the Olympics or the World Championships. Until about 2016, one was the established star India relied upon for medals and glory on the international stage. The other was a talented understudy, inconsistent and yet mesmerizing. But then the Rio Olympics changed it all. Many would say that Sindhu is the greatest badminton player India has ever had. Others would argue that she is the second greatest after Saina. The question really comes down to, is Sindhu better than Saina? Well, there is only one way to find out. We are going to compare the two shuttlers side by side. We'll take a look at their playing styles, achievements, accolades and head-to-head record. And you can also have your say in the comment section. But let's get started. Even though they have trained under the same coach for large parts of their career, Sindhu has remained a distinctly different shuttler to Saina. Saina's fighting spirit, aggression and hunger to win made her stand out. Her trademark calmness on court helps her deal with pesky opponents who try to rattle her with body smashes and stares. With time, Sindhu has also polished her game following her own rigorous efforts. At one time, she had the tendency of losing matches from winning positions, but now she has worked it out. She is cool as a cucumber and hardly ever seems annoyed. Standing tall at 5'11", Sindhu likes to pack her shots with a lot of power. Saina, however, is a rally player who wears down the opponent and pounces on the mistakes of others. From the back of the court, Saina is a better player than Sindhu, with better court coverage. Saina is a delightful dribbler at the net. Sindhu's net game is good, but not as effective as that of prime Saina. But they're both solid defensively. Having said all this, our vote goes to Saina as the more complete player who, at her prime, would devastate any opposition. If we want to take a look at the achievements, then here is how the two players stand. Saina has played 629 matches in her career so far and has won 433 of them with a win percentage of 69%. She has been world number 1 and has won a total of 24 career titles. Sindhu, on the other hand, has played 468 matches, winning 328 of those. Her winning percentage stands slightly above Saina's 69% at 70%. Her career high ranking has been 2 and she has won a total of 15 career titles so far. As we can see, Saina is slightly ahead in this regard, but Sindhu is 5 years younger to her and still has her best years ahead of her. She has time on her hand to emulate Saina and possibly even go further. If anything, Sindhu's medals at the biggest stages are a testament to that. While Saina has one Olympic bronze medal, 2 world championship medals, a silver and a bronze, Sindhu on the other hand has a silver at the Olympics and 5 world championship medals, which includes 1 gold medal, 2 silver medals and 2 bronze medals. Sindhu is a big tournament player and in this regard she is way ahead of her compatriot Saina. Lastly, we take a look at the Saina and Sindhu's head-to-head record. In 4 meetings, Saina has had the last laugh 3 times, thus having the edge. In conclusion, keeping everything in mind, we see that Saina slightly edges ahead of Sindhu despite the latter's big wins on the international stage. If not for the head-to-head record and the overall career titles, I would have to say Sindhu would have surely been the more iconic star at the moment, but still, she has time to overtake Saina, doesn't she?